ఇది రన్నింగ్ నోట్స్ మీరు రాసుకోవాలి కొంచెం. అటామిక్ స్ట్రక్చర్లో మనకి ఇంపార్టెంట్ పాయింట్స్, ఆటంలో ఉండే పార్టికల్స్ ఏంటి, ఫండమెంటల్ పార్టికల్స్ ఇన్ ది ఆటమ్, ప్రోటాన్, ఎలక్ట్రాన్, న్యూట్రాన్, వాటి మాస్ నెంబర్స్ కావాలి. ఇప్పుడు ప్రోటాన్ సింబల్ పి, దీని మాస్ 1.6278 × 10⁻²⁸ kg. అలాగే మాస్ ఆఫ్ న్యూట్రాన్, మాస్ ఆఫ్ న్యూట్రాన్ ఇస్ 1.624 × 10⁻²⁸ kg. మాస్ ఆఫ్ ఎలక్ట్రాన్ 9.1 × 10⁻³⁶ kg. దీస్ ఆర్ ది మాసెస్ ఆఫ్ ది ఫండమెంటల్ పార్టికల్స్. దీస్ ఆర్ మోస్ట్ ఇంపార్టెంట్. నెక్స్ట్ ఛార్జ్ ఆఫ్ ఎలక్ట్రాన్ ఇస్ 1.602 × 10⁻¹⁹ కూలంబ్స్. ఇట్ ఈస్ మైనస్ సైన్. మాస్ ఆఫ్ ప్రోటాన్ ఇస్ ప్లస్ 1.602 × 10⁻¹⁹ కూలంబ్స్. న్యూట్రాన్ ఇస్ ద ఛార్జ్లెస్ పార్టికల్. దీస్ ఫండమెంటల్ పార్టికల్స్ ఆర్ ఇంపార్టెంట్. నౌ స్పెసిఫిక్ ఛార్జ్, స్పెసిఫిక్ ఛార్జ్, స్పెసిఫిక్ ఛార్జ్ ఇస్ నథింగ్ బట్ ఛార్జ్ పర్ యూనిట్ మాస్, ఛార్జ్ బై మాస్. నౌ ద స్పెసిఫిక్ ఛార్జ్ ఆఫ్ ఎలక్ట్రాన్, స్పెసిఫిక్ ఛార్జ్ ఆఫ్ ఎలక్ట్రాన్ EM, మాస్ బై ఛార్జ్. అంటే ఛార్జ్ బై మాస్, ఛార్జ్ ఇస్ ఈక్వల్ టు EM, ఈజ్ ఈక్వల్ టు 1.602 × 10⁻¹⁹ by mass of the electron 9.1 × 10⁻³⁶ kg. If it is simplified this, we get the value 1.57 × 10⁻¹⁹ coulomb per kg. This is the specific charge of electron, E by M. Next, what are the specific charges of alpha particle, proton, electron and the neutron, and give their order? Important bit. This is the important bit. Alpha particle, proton, electron, neutron. What is the symbol of alpha particle? Alpha is equal to 2He4, helium particle, mass 4 units, charge 2 units. Lower script indicates the charge, upper script indicates the mass. Now, proton is represented as 1H1. Next, electron is represented as −1E0. Charge is −1, mass almost equal to 0. Neutron, 0N1, mass, charge 0, mass 1 unit. Therefore, specific charge of alpha particle is charge 2 units, mass 4 units, it is equal to 1/2. Like specific charge of proton, 1/1. Specific charge of electron, charge 1 unit, mass 0, nearly infinity when compared to these two. Next, specific charge of neutron, 1/1, 1. So highest specific charge is electron, infinite value. Next one is neutron, 0/1, charge 0/1, it is 0. So highest value electron is greater than, next one proton is greater than, alpha particle is greater than neutron. This is the order of specific charge of these four particles. It is one of the important bit. So specific charge is nothing but charge per unit mass. In case of electron, the value is 1.57 into 10 power 11 coulomb per kilogram. This power is important, 10 power 11 coulomb per kg. Next, specific charge order of alpha for the proton, electron, neutron are in the form of electron greater than, proton greater than, alpha greater than, neutron. Next, initially electrons are called cathode rays. Cathode rays are nothing but electrons. They are discovered by J.J. Thomson, electrons. Cathode rays are obtained from, is it from cathode or anode? Cathode rays are obtained from cathode and they are most towards anode. Next, the television picture tubes are made by cathode ray tubes. Television picture tubes are made by cathode ray tubes. That's the important bit. Cathode ray tubes are television picture tubes. Next. Television picture tubes are made by cathode ray tubes. Cathode ray discharge tubes. Next. In atomic models, the important atomic model is Bohr's atomic model. Bohr's atomic model. Here we discuss only the most important topics only. J.J. Thomson even is negligible. They are not asked. Bohr's atomic model is based on Planck's quantum theory. Bohr's atomic model is based on the Planck's quantum theory. In Planck's quantum theory is considered, electrons undergo excitation and de-excitation. If a black body, Planck's quantum theory explains the black body radiation. What is black body? A perfect absorber and a perfect emitter of radiation energy. This is called black body. Black body absorbs energy and emits the energy. The perfect absorber, perfect emitter. From upper surface, it takes energy. From the lower surface, it emits energy. How much energy it gains, the same energy will be returned to back. How it is possible? According to Planck's, it is possible due to vibration of charged particles. The charged particles are nothing but electrons. When light energy or any energy focused on black body, the electrons undergo excitation. Electrons gains this energy, undergo excitation. Excited electron come back to ground state immediately. If it is excited by taking energy, when it undergo de-excitation, it loses energy. That energy is emitted. This is called vibration. This is a vibration of electrons or the result. For the photoelectric, this is the black body energy of the radiation. So black body emits and absorbs energy is due to vibration of charged particles. This point is taken the Bohr's into its atomic model. Okay, Bohr's atomic model is based on Planck quantum theory. The most important point in the Planck quantum theory is the black body radiation. Black body absorbs energy and emits energy. Because of when light energy or any form of energy focused on black body, the electrons present in the black body undergo excitation. Again, within a fraction of a second, the excited electron come back to ground state. During de-excitation, this higher level to lower level is called de-excitation. During de-excitation, they emits energy. Okay? That's why black body absorbs energy and emits energy. This is called a vibration of electron. Due to the vibration of electrons, black body absorbs and emits energy continuously. So, Bohr's proposal that electrons revolves in the atomic orbits. Electrons revolves around the nucleus in a closed circular paths. The circular orbits are called stationary orbits. The circular orbits are called stationary orbits because the energy of electron in the circular orbit is constant. If electron revolves in this orbit, its energy remains constant. That is, it never loses or never gains energy when revolving in the same orbit. The circular orbits are designated by K, L and M and so on. K and it is the first orbit, L is nothing but second orbit, M is third orbit. So according to Bohr's, electrons revolves around the nucleus in a closed circular paths with a fixed energy and a high velocity. The energy is fixed in these orbits. Hence, these orbits are called stationary orbits. The important point is, when electron revolves in the circular orbit, it makes the angular momentum. The electron, when revolves in the circular orbit, it maintains the angular momentum. The angular momentum of electron in the circular orbit is quantized. The angular momentum of electron in the circular orbit is quantized. What is meant by quantization? If it revolves in the first orbit, suppose its value is 1. When it revolves in the second orbit, its value should be doubled. And 2 into 1, 2 over. If it is revolves in first orbit, value is suppose ax. In second orbit, it should be exactly equal to 2x. And if it lies in third orbit, its value should be 3x. 1x, 2x, 3x. Integral multiples of some quantity is called a quantization. In case of Bohr's theory, angular momentum mvr is equal to n into h by 2 pi. This is called Bohr's quantum condition. Mvr is equal to n into h by 2 pi. It is called Bohr's quantum condition. Here m is mass of electron, v velocity of electron, r radius of orbit, n is integer, orbit number 1, 2, 3 and so on. H is Planck's constant. The values are 6.625 into 10 power minus 34 joule into second. Not joule by second, it is joule into second. Joule second value is taken in MKS system. And 6.625 into 10 power minus 27 erg second. It is taken in CGS system. For MKS system, H value is this. And in CGS system, it is 10 power minus 27 erg into second. Not erg by second, erg into second and joule into second. H Planck's constant. These two values are used in the problems. Next, n integer 1, 2, 3. Next, electrons' energy changes only when they move from one orbit into other. If electron excited from lower level to higher level, then energy is absorbed. If electron de-excited, the energy is released. The energy change is given by delta E is equal to E2 minus E1, which is equal to h nu. E2 minus E1 is equal to h nu. Delta E is equal to E2 minus E1 is equal to h nu. H is Planck's constant. Nu is the frequency of electron. This nu is equal to frequency of electron. E2 is higher energy level. E1 lower energy level. The energy difference is given by delta E. It is, should be equal to h nu. These two formulas are important. MVR is equal to nh by 2 pi. And delta E is equal to E2 minus E1 is equal to h nu. Next. What is atomic spectrum? What is atomic spectrum? If you consider a discharge tube, a glass tube, it consists of two electrodes. They applied a high voltage. A gas is considered to in it. If the gas consists of gases atoms, only atoms, the electrons in the atoms are excited when applying the high voltage. And again, they are de-excited. During excitation and de-excitation, they emit energy in the form of light. Any substance is heated either by electricity or direct heating. The electrons in the atoms are excited. Again, they are immediately undergo de-excitation. During de-excitation, they emit light energy. When this light energy passed into prism, we get the spectral lines. This is the spectrum. And a spectrum created by gaseous atoms is called atomic spectrum. If the substance consists of gaseous molecules, like CO2 molecules or N2 molecules, then we get the spectrum again. That spectrum is called molecular spectrum. If atoms are present in the discharge tube, the spectrum obtained is called atomic spectrum. If molecules are present in it, they are called molecular spectrum. So the spectrum created by gaseous atoms is called atomic spectrum. Atomic spectrum contains continuous lines, but they are distinct and visible in different lines. Next, if molecules are present, the spectrum is called molecular spectrum. Molecular spectrum consists of continuous bands like this. This is a band. And again, this is a band. Like this is a band. This is called band spectrum. It is called line spectrum. Line spectrums are given by atoms. Band spectrum is given by molecules. This is an important. Atomic spectrum is nothing but line spectrum. Molecular spectrum is nothing but a band spectrum. Molecular spectrum is nothing but band spectrum. Listen here. So when substance is heated, then atoms, the electrons present in the substance undergo excitation and de-excitation. During this excitation and de-excitation, light energy is emitted. You heat the substance in any form, and you give the energy to the substance in any form. If it is light energy or heat energy or electrical energy, any type of energy given to the system or substance, but it emits only energy in the form of light. The substance is heated or given to energy in any form. And the substance is activated or gives to energy by either electricity or heat energy or light energy. Any form energy given to the substance, but it emits only energy in the form of light. When this light passes through the prism, you get the spectrum. If here atoms are present, you get the atomic spectrum. It consists of distinct continuous lines. If your substance contains molecules, then you get the band spectrum. The band spectrum consists of continuous bands, like a rainbow type. In a rainbow, bands are closer to each other. The type of spectrum is called band spectrum. Suppose if the substance consists of helium, if you consider the gas is only helium, then you get either atomic spectrum or molecular spectrum. If the gas consists of helium, it is a helium gas. During this process, you get either atomic spectrum or band spectrum. Atomic spectrum, because these are atoms, helium. If the gas is filled with chlorine gas, then you get the band spectrum, because chlorine are molecules. Another, just like hydrogen atoms are placed here. Hydrogen atoms are placed here. When hydrogen atoms are filled in the discharge tube, and they get the spectrum. That is called hydrogen atomic spectrum. The hydrogen atomic spectrum consists of how many lines, how many types of lines? Hydrogen atomic spectrum consists of 5 types of series. There are so many lines, that lines are divided into 5 types. What are that series? Hydrogen atomic spectrum. It consists of 5 series. First one, Lyman. Lyman series. Second one is Balmer series. Third one is Paschen series. Fourth one is Brackett. Fifth one is Fund. These are the 5 spectral types, the 5 types of spectral lines in atomic spectrum. Bohr given the values N1 and N2. N1 is the ground state of the region. N2 is the higher energy level. N1 and N2 are the orbits. This is a lower energy orbit. It indicates the higher energy orbit. For Lyman series, N1 is always 1. N2 is 2, 3, 4 and so on. For Balmer series, N1 is 2, N2 is equal to 3, 4, 5 and so on. Paschen series is 3, it is 4, 5, 6 and so on. Brackett series is 4, it is 5, 6, 7 and so on. It is 5, it is 6, 7, 8 and so on. These are the N1 and N2 values for this series. Next, Lyman series is formed in UV region. Balmer series is formed in visible region. Paschen series formed in near IR. Brackett is middle IR. Fund series is far IR. That is, all the 3 series are obtained in infrared regions. Lyman series, UV region. Balmer series, visible region. Paschen series, near IR. Brackett IR, Fund IR. To calculate the wavelength of every spectral line in hydrogen atomic spectrum, Rydberg give an equation. Rydberg equation, it is the important. Rydberg's equation. Rydberg equation, nu bar is equal to nothing but a wave number, nu bar. Nu bar should be equal to 1 by lambda. It is equal to R into 1 by N1 square minus 1 by N2 square into Z square, where N1, N2 are the integers given from this table. Z is atomic number. Bohr explains the hydrogen atomic spectrum and also some other spectra. They contain single electron. Single electron spectra are explained. What are that spectra? Hydrogen, hydrogen atom spectrum and H2+. H2 has 2 electrons. H2 molecule, 2 electrons. But plus means loses 1 electron. So 2 hydrogen molecule ion. The hydrogen ion. Hydrogen ion is other, H+. But it is a molecular ion. Hydrogen molecular ion consists of 1 electron. And similarly, helium. Helium has 2 electrons, but a plus. It means it consists of 1 electron. Next, lithium. Lithium has 3 electrons. Lithium. Lithium plus 2 consists of only 1 electron. Next, beryllium. Beryllium has 4 electrons. Beryllium plus 3. These 5 species spectra are explained by Bohr. Remaining spectra explanation is failed. అన్నది అందులో బోస్ థియరీ ఎక్స్ప్లెయిన్స్ ద సింగిల్ ఎలక్ట్రాన్ స్పెక్ట్రా స్పీసెస్. ద స్పీసెస్ ఆర్ హైడ్రోజన్ ఆటమ్, హైడ్రోజన్ మాలిక్యులర్ అయాన్, హీలియం అయాన్, లిథియం అయాన్, బెరీలియం అయాన్. దిస్ ఇస్ ద ఇంపార్టెంట్ పాయింట్. బోర్స్ ఎక్స్ప్లెయిన్స్ ద సింగిల్ ఎలక్ట్రాన్ స్పెక్ట్రా. దిస్ ఆర్ హెచ్ఏ, H2 ప్లస్, HE ప్లస్, LI ప్లస్ 2, BE ప్లస్ 3. ఓన్లీ దీస్ 5 స్పెక్ట్రాస్ హీ ఎక్స్ప్లెయిన్. హీ కుడ్ నాట్ ఎక్స్ప్లెయిన్ ద మల్టీ ఎలక్ట్రాన్ స్పెక్ట్రా. నెక్స్ట్, వాట్ ఈస్ ద వేవ్ లెంగ్త్ ఆఫ్ హెచ్ బీటా లైన్ ఆఫ్ బామర్ సిరీస్? వేవ్ లెంగ్త్ ఫర్ హెచ్ బీటా లైన్ ఆఫ్ బామర్ సిరీస్. ద ప్రాబ్లమ్స్ ఆన్ దిస్ ఫార్ములా ఆర్ వెరీ ఇంపార్టెంట్. దే ఆస్క్ లైక్ దిస్, వాట్ ఈస్ ద వేవ్ లెంగ్త్ ఆఫ్ హెచ్ బీటా లైన్ ఆఫ్ బామర్ సిరీస్? ఫర్ బామర్ సిరీస్ N1 వాల్యూ, అంటే వి క్యాలిక్యులేట్ ల్యాంబ్డా అకార్డింగ్ టు దిస్ ఈక్వేషన్. ఫర్ దిస్ ఈక్వేషన్, ఫర్ బామర్ సిరీస్ N1 ఈజ్ ఆల్వేస్ 2. ఫర్ ఎనీ లైన్ ఇన్ బామర్ సిరీస్ N1 ఈజ్ ఈక్వల్ టు 2. ఫర్ ఎనీ లైన్, వెదర్ ఇట్ ఈస్ ఫస్ట్ లైన్ ఆర్ సెకండ్ లైన్ ఆర్ థర్డ్ లైన్, ఫర్ బామర్ సిరీస్ ఇస్ కన్సిడర్డ్ N1 షుడ్ బి 2. N2 depends on the number of line. Here asked line is H beta. H alpha means first line. H alpha means first line. H beta is second. H delta, H gamma is third. H delta is nothing but 4. Alpha is 1, beta is 2, gamma is 3, delta is 4. Here H beta line is asked. But in case of second line, beta means second line, you consider the second value of N2 in Balmer series. It is for first line, it is for second line, it is for third line. But if for Balmer second line, when Balmer series is considered, N1 should be 2, N2 according to the number of line. They ask for the second line, H beta, second line. So you consider the N2 in the second value, that is 4. So N2 is equal to 4. N2 is equal to 4. Do you understand this? For in case of Balmer series, for Balmer series N1 should be 2. N2 value is taken according to the number of line. They ask for the second line, so you should consider the second value from this. If they ask for third line, then N2 should be 5. If it is H alpha, that is first. First of first value. They ask for the bracket second line. If a bracket is considered, N1 should be 4. For second line, you take the second value from this, 6. Now, we calculate H beta line, wavelength of H beta line. For hydrogen spectrum, H means hydrogen. For hydrogen spectrum, Z is equal to 1. Substituted these values in. 1 by lambda is equal to, R value is called Rydberg constant, it is remains as it is, into 1 by 2 square minus 1 by 4 square into Z is 1 square. So R into 1 by 4 minus 1 by 16 in LCM is 16, 4 minus 1 into R, this is going to 3R by 16. This is wave number, but wavelength lambda is equal to 16 by 3R centimeter. This is the value, 16 by 3R centimeter. They are not asked the simplification, and the answers exist in the form of R. R undayatle undayi undadi, but R exists in a form lone manam calculate cheyali. నెక్స్ట్ క్యాలిక్యులేట్ ద వన్. what is the wave number of h beta line of partial series? So try that problem. Wave number nu bar, wave number for h beta line of a partial series, nu bar for h beta line of partial series. Nu bar for h beta line of partial series. For h beta, that is second line. For partial series, for partial series, n1 is equal to 3. It is n2 is equal to beta line space second line. For beta, it's the value is 5. Second value is 5. N2 is equal to 5. For hydrogen atom, Z is equal to 1. Therefore, nu bar is equal to R into 1 by 3 square minus 1 by 5 square into 1 square. And R into 1 by 9 minus 1 by 25. Therefore, LCM is 225. 9 into 25, 225. 25 minus 9. And a 16R by 225 centimeter inverse. This is the value. Next, you calculate the wave number of bracket series in helium plus spectrum. Next, we calculate the wave number of h beta, the wave number of second line. Wave number for second line in H plus spectrum of bracket series. Bracket series. Wave number for second line in HE plus spectrum of a bracket series. Helium plus spectrum of bracket series. For helium plus, Z is equal to 2. Atomic number of helium, Z is equal to 2. Next, for bracket series, N1 is equal to, in a bracket series, N1 should be 4. N2 is equal to, for second line, you consider the second value in a bracket. Second value of bracket series is 6. N2 is equal to 6. Therefore, nu bar is equal to R into 1 by 4 square minus 1 by 6 square into 2 square. Z is equal to 2. Now, R into 1 by 16 minus 1 by 36 into 4. 4, when taken into the bracket, you get R is equal to 4 by 16 minus 4 by 36. Therefore, R into 1 by 4 minus 1 by 9. LCM is equal to 36. This is 9 minus 4. R. And a 5R by 36. Wave number is unit centimeter inverse. 5R by 36. Next, what is the wave number of limiting line of Lyman series? Next question. What is the wave number of limiting line? Wave number of limiting line of Lyman series. Lyman series of hydrogen spectrum. What is the wave number of limiting line of Lyman series of hydrogen spectrum? What is meant by limiting line? The last line of the series is called a limiting line. For last line, n2 should be infinity. It is 1, 2, 3, the 2, 3, 4 and so on, up to infinity. So, in case of limiting line, n2 should be infinite for any series. For limiting line of any series, n2 should be considered to infinity. So, when Lyman series, for Lyman series, n1 is equal to 1, for limiting line, limiting line means ending line, limiting line, n2 should be infinity. For hydrogen atom, z is equal to 1. For hydrogen atom, z is equal to 1. Therefore, wave number nu bar is equal to r into 1 by 1 square minus 1 by infinity square. Something by infinity is nothing but 0. Something by infinity is equal to 0. So it is r into 1 by 1 square is 1 minus 1 by infinity square is 0. So it is r centimeter inverse. R centimeter inverse. Next. R is called Rydberg constant. Rydberg constant. Its value 1.09 into 10 power 5 centimeter inverse or 1.09 into 10 power 7 meter inverse. R value is Rydberg constant. Its value 1.09 into 10 power 5 centimeter inverse or 1.09 into 10 power 7 meter inverse. Actually, they asked the answers like in the form of R. Not a calculation is required. Well, R form lone untai. Next, find the ratio of wavelengths of next problem. Find the ratio of wavelengths of second line of Lyman series and the first line of Balmer series. Find the ratio of wavelength of first line of Lyman series and the second line of Balmer series in a hydrogen spectrum. And you want to calculate lambda of Lyman series first line by lambda of Balmer series in second line. You calculate the ratio of these two wavelengths. First, 1 by new and a formula 1 by lambda Lyman is equal to, and 1 by lambda is equal to r into 1 by n1. What is the value of n1 for Lyman series? For Lyman, n1 is equal to 1 square minus 1 by n2 for first line. For first line, n2 is equal to 2 square into for hydrogen z1 h square by 1 by lambda of Balmer series is equal to r into for Balmer n1 is equal to 2 square minus 1 by for second line. For second line, you consider the second value here 4 1 by 4 square. If for a hydrogen z is equal to 1, this is the ratio. Therefore, you get the lambda Balmer by lambda L. These two values are simplified. Lambda B goes to numerator. Lambda B by lambda L is equal to R should be cancelled. LCM is 4 here. 4 minus 1. Here LCM is 16. 16 minus 4. That is 3 by 4 into 16 by 12. 4 cancelled in 4 times, 3 cancelled again in 4 times. Therefore, answer is equal to 1. So 16 by 12. 3 in 4 times. So answer is 1. Okay? And that is the wavelength of first line of Bhamasri should be equal to wavelength of second line of Bhamasri. Lyman first line wavelength is equal to Bhamar second line. Is that correct line of calculation? Okay. Next. How many spectral lines are obtained during the transition of electron? This is the most important point. Number of spectral lines obtained during the de-excitation of electron. It is equal to number of spectral lines is equal to sigma N2 minus N1. Sigma N2 minus N1. Number of spectral lines. N2 is the higher energy orbit. N1 is the lower energy orbit. N2 higher orbit. Higher orbit. N1 lower orbit. Higher orbit, lower orbit. N2 higher orbit, N1 lower orbit. In any spectrum, if electron de-excites from fifth orbit to first orbit, then how many spectral lines are obtained? If electron de-excites from fifth orbit to first orbit, then how many spectral lines are obtained? Fifth orbit N d is equal to 5. Sigma 5 minus 1. Sigma 4. Sigma 4 is nothing but 4 plus 3 plus 2 plus 1. Total is equal to 10 lines. 10 spectral lines are obtained. Number of spectral lines, sigma N2 minus N1. N2 higher orbit, N1 lower orbit. If electron de-excites from 5th orbit to 1st orbit. 5th orbit to 1st orbit. Then the spectral length sigma 5 minus 1, that is equal to 4. 4 plus 3 plus 2 plus 1. If electron come back from any higher energy orbit to 1st orbit, then which series is obtained? If electrons come back from higher orbit to lower orbit, then which series is obtained? 5th to 1, it is and a when you consider hydrogen atomic spectrum, this is the ground state, E1 level. This is E2, first, second orbit, E3, third orbit, E4, E5, E6, E7. When the number increases, the energy gap between the orbits decreases. From bottom to top, energy increase. But the difference between energy values are decreases. This is first orbit. It is second orbit, the third orbit, fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh. If electron de-excites from any higher level to ground state, first orbit, Lyman series is obtained. Any higher orbit to lower orbit. From 2 to 1 also, you get the Lyman. If excited electron de-excites from any higher energy level into N is equal to 1 level, Lyman series obtained. If it is de-excited from any higher level to only second orbit, then you get the visible region. That is, Bhamar series is obtained. From any level to first level, Lyman series. From any level to second level, Bhamar. Similarly, any higher level into third level, any higher into third, then you get the Paschen. Like any higher to fourth, then you get the bracket. Like any higher to fifth level, Paschen, the Fund series is formed. Cut up to 1, Lyman series, up to 2, Bhamar, up to 3, Paschen, up to 4, bracket, up to 5, Fund series. Here, electron de-excited from higher level to first level. So there exists some Lyman series lines. How many Lyman series are obtained in this case? The first figure indicates the Lyman. Second figure indicates Bhamar. Third figure indicates partial. The bracket. No fund service is obtained. Another, Lyman lines are 4, bracket lines are 3, fashions lines are 2, bracket series are 1. Another, when you design the graph like this, this is the first orbit, second orbit, third orbit, fourth, fifth. Fifth to 1. Alage 4 to 1, 3 to 1, 2 to 1, up to 1 is Riemann. These 4 lines are this 4. And a electron first deaccelerates from 5th orbit to directly into 1st orbit. Or first it jumps from 5th to 4, later 4 to 1. Deacceleration is stepwise. Excitation is a single step, but deacceleration is stepwise. అలాగే ఇఫ్ ఎలక్ట్రాన్ ఫస్ట్ డిఎక్సెస్ ఫ్రమ్ ఫిఫ్త్ ఆర్బిట్ టు థర్డ్ లాటర్ జంప్స్ టు 1. దిస్ 3-2-1 గివ్స్ ద లైమన్ సిరీస్. ఆ సారీ 2-2-1 గివ్స్ ద లైమన్ సిరీస్. మరి నెక్స్ట్ ఇఫ్ ఎలక్ట్రాన్ డిఎక్సెస్ ఫ్రమ్ హైయర్ లెవెల్ టు సెకండ్ ఆర్బిట్ ఓన్లీ, ఫస్ట్ ఇట్ డిఎక్సెస్ అప్ టు 2 లాటర్ 1, దిస్ గోస్ టు లైమన్, దిస్ గోస్ టు బామర్. దిస్ లైన్ గోస్ టు బామర్ సిరీస్, దిస్ లైన్ గోస్ టు లైమన్ సిరీస్. Or if electron deaccelerates from 4th to 2 or 3 to 2, these 3 lines are obtained in Balmer series. If it deaccelerates from higher level to 3rd or the 5th to 3rd or 4th to 3rd, then you get the 3rd partial. Only 5th to 1, you get the bracket. These type of deaccelerations exist. So 10 lines are formed. That lines are calculated according to this formula. Sigma N2 minus N1. Next, another question. If electron deaccelerates from 7th orbit to 2nd orbit. If electron deaccelerated from 7th orbit to 2nd orbit. Then how many spectral lines and how many Balmer lines are formed? How many spectral lines and how many Balmer lines are formed? 7th to 2. Here N2 is 7, N1 is equal to sigma 5. That is 5 plus 4 plus 3 plus 2 plus 1, 15 spectral lines are obtained. Total lines are 15. In that lens, how many Balmer lines are formed? Don't draw the spectrum. You observe this.
5, sir.
Spectrum. Okay, 5 is correct. Spectrum is 7 to 2. Up to 2 is Balmer series. There exists no Lyman. Cut a Lyman or these are 5 Balmer, partial, bracket, fund. And all these lines goes to fund series. So 5 are the number lines. If it is 7-2-1, second value Balmer. If it is 7-2-1, Lyman also exists. First number always first series. In this case, there is no Lyman. So the first lines are Balmer. If his spectrum is formed from 5 to 3, up to 3 means partial, and a sigma 5 minus 3, sigma 2, 2 plus 1, these two lines are partial, this one line is bracket. Do you understand this? Okay. This is the important concept, number of spectral lines. Next. The formula of radius of orbit. According to Bohr's theory, radius of orbit. What is the formula? N square H square by 4 pi square m into ze square n square h square by 4 pi square m into ze square. This is the radius of orbit. N is the orbit number, h Planck constant, mass of electron, charge of electron, z. When they simplify these constants, you get the 0.529 into n square by z angstrom. When they simplify the values other than n and z, you get the radius 0.529 into n square by z, radius of orbit. Next, energy of electron minus 2 pi square m z square e power 4 by n square h square minus 2 pi square m z square e power 4 by n square h square. Here also, except z and n, all are the other values are constants. By simplify this value, you get minus 13.6 into z square by n square electron volt per atom, or minus 2.18 into z square by n square joule per atom. In case of joules, the constant is minus 2.18. In case of electron volt, the constant is minus 13.6. Or it is minus 1312 into z square by n square kilojoules per mole. In case of kilojoules per mole, the constant becomes 1312. 1312. These three values are important, three formulas are important. Next, kinetic energy of electron. Kinetic energy means half into mass into velocity square. Just to derive the formula, according to Bohr's concept, mvr is equal to nh by 2 pi. Therefore, v is equal to nh by 2 pi mr. V is equal to nh by 2 pi mr. Substituted the value of v in kinetic energy. Now, kinetic energy ke is equal to half into m into v. nh square by 2 pi mr whole square and half into m into n square h power 4 by 4 pi square m square r square. M will be cancelled here. So it is n square h power 4 by 8 pi square m r square. This is the kinetic energy formula. Okay? Square SM. V is equal to NH by 2 pi MR. Square. N square H square by 8 pi square MR square. Kinetic energy. Energy of electron minus 2 pi square m z square e power 4 by n square h square. Right? So, it is the formula again. N square h square by 8 pi square m r square. R is the radius of orbit. Radius of orbit. Another formula, kinetic energy is equal to z e square by 2 r. Ze square by 2R. This is another formula of kinetic energy. Ze square by 2R. Next, potential energy of electron. potential energy of electron PE is equal to minus ZE square by R. Potential energy of electron is equal to minus ZE square by R. Alage total energy of electron TE, total energy is equal to minus ZE square by 2R. Minus ZE square by 2R. Total energy of electron minus ZE square by 2R. KE for another formula, ZE square by 2R, potential energy minus ZE square by R, total energy minus ZE square by 2R. Now, what is the ratio of kinetic energy to total energy? KE is to TE. KE is ZE square by 2R is to TE minus ZE square by 2R. And 1 is to minus 1. And the value is same, just the sign is different in case of kinetic energy and total energy. Next, potential energy to total energy ratio. Potential energy is minus ZE square by R. Total energy minus ZE square by 2R. Therefore, it is 1 is to 1 by 2 or 2 is to 1. So potential energy is twice than that of total energy. Potential energy is twice than that of total energy. P is to T is 2 is to 1. Next. Ratio of kinetic energy is to potential energy. K is a minus ZE square by, ZE square by 2R KE. PE is equal to minus ZE square by R. Therefore, 1 by 2 is to minus 1 or 1 is to minus 2. 1 is to minus 2. These ratios are important. All this is the Bohr's concept. In MCET, you get the one bit from Bohr's concept. Compulsory bit from Bohr's concept. The spectral lines are energies or ratios. In case of mains, maximum bit is obtained from Bohr's or quantum mechanics. Next, it goes into quantum mechanics. What is meant by quantum mechanics? The science deals the consideration of particle and the wave nature of electron is called quantum mechanics. The science which deals the consideration of particle nature and the wave nature of electron is called quantum mechanics. The major concepts in quantum mechanics are de Broglie's theory. De Broglie's theory. And the second one is Heisenberg. Heisenberg's uncertainty principle. De Broglie's theory, Heisenberg uncertainty principle. These two are the important leads of quantum mechanics. De Broglie's theory, Heisenberg uncertainty principle. What is the concept of De Broglie's theory? Every particle in motion, particle means it has particle nature. When it is in motion, it exhibits wave character. Every particle in motion exhibits wave nature. That a wave is called a matter wave, and its wavelength is given by lambda is equal to h by mv. Every particle in motion exhibits wave nature, and the waves are called matter waves, and the wavelength of the particle is given by lambda is equal to h by mv. Next, MV is equal to, MV is rewritten as half into or 2 into half into M square V square MV. If what is the kinetic energy? Kinetic energy is equal to half MV square. It can be written as half into M into M square V square. Therefore, M square V square is equal to 2M into KE. Therefore, MV is equal to root 2M into KE. So, another formula of de Broglie wavelength lambda is equal to H by MV. MV means root 2M into KE. When kinetic energy is given, the wavelength is equal to H by root 2M into KV. MV is the mass of the particle. M is the mass of the particle. KE kinetic energy. Also, KE is directly proportional to or is equal to E into voltage. Charge into voltage. Kinetic energy. So, in that case, lambda is equal to H by root 2M into EV. V is potential, E is charge. V is the potential, E is the charge. 2M EV. These three formulas are important de Broglie's theory. So, according to de Broglie's theory, every particle in motion acts as a wave of wavelength lambda is equal to H by MV. MV is also written as 2M into KE root. Or KE is nothing but EV, charge into potential. E is the charge, V is the potential. So 2M into EV. These three are the formulas of de Broglie's. Next. In atomic orbits, electron waves are exist as a stationary waves. Suppose this is the atomic orbit. Electron is also a microparticle. Mass is equal to 10 power minus 31 kg. Smaller mass particles are called microparticles. When mass is small, then what is the wavelength? Because lambda is equal to H by MV. If mass is very small, lambda is maximum. M is very small, lambda is maximum. So electrons are microscopic particles. So they have definitely wave nature. Because they are rotate, they are revolve around the nucleus. And they are in motion. Electrons are in motion and having lower mass. So they should have a wavelength. So electrons behaves like waves. When rotate in the, when revolves in the atomic orbits. That waves are exist as stationary waves. So electrons are microparticles. And in atomic orbits, they exist as stationary waves. Stationary wave means the wave is formed from this point, goes to like this wave type, and exactly coincide with this. Then it will be continuous movement. So electron cannot be collapsed. If electron moves like this in the atomic orbits, the kalakunda. This is called destructive wave. Electron motion is not continuous if electron wave exists like this. If it exists like this, it is a continuous wave. That is called stationary wave. It is destructive wave. Stationary wave avalante lambda senundali. This is the wavelength lambda. It is 1 lambda. It is 2nd lambda. It is 3rd lambda. It is a 4th lambda, 5th lambda, 5th lambda, 5 lambda. If it exists like this, here, these are not a continuous wave. It is a wave lambda, it is a lambda, alage, it is a lambda, it is a lambda. But it is not a continuous lambda. Not a coincide. It is not perfect lambda. And it is odd number of waves. It is a number of waves, integral multiples of lambda. this length of orbit is called circumference of orbit. Length of orbit is circumference of orbit. If a circumference of orbit is equal to n lambda, then the wave is the stationary wave. It is not equal to n lambda, it is a destructive wave. But according to Bose, electrons revolve around the nucleus in a closed circular path with a different amount of energy. So electron neither lose nor gains the energy when revolves in the orbit. So it should be stationary wave, constant energy wave. Stationary gavati, circumference of orbit, mv adi, and the circumference of orbit formula, 2 pi r. Circumference of orbit 2 pi r is equal to n lambda. If it satisfies this formula of the electron wave, the wave is a stationary wave. Here, not equal to n lambda. This is 1 lambda, 2 lambda, 3 lambda, 4 lambda. 5th lambda is not equal. It is not a perfect lambda. So, circumference of orbit is not equal to n lambda. That is a destructive wave. But according to Bohr, the atom is stable when the stable electron moves in the continuous energy form. So they should satisfy the formula 2 pi r is equal to n lambda. If 2 pi r is equal to n lambda, 2 pi r circumference of orbit, n is the number of orbit, lambda means h by mv according to de Broglie. Rewrite this equation, we get mvr is equal to mv at this end. 2 pi goes to this side, nh by 2 pi. MVR is equal to nh by 2 pi. This is the Bohr quantum condition. Bohr quantum condition obtained from de Broglie's theory. Thus, de Broglie's theory supports the Bohr's theory. Bohr explained the atomic structure when electron is considered as only particle form. De Broglie explained the atomic structure when electron is considered as a wave. So, electron should have wave nature and particle nature. As both forms are coincide. This consideration is called quantum mechanics. Do you understand? De Broglie considered electron as wave and obtained an equation 2 pi r is equal to n lambda. Rewrite this equation, mvr is equal to nh by 2 pi. Exactly same equation is given by Bohr. Bohr considered electron as the particle. Whether electron is considered as a particle or a wave, the angular momentum is equal to nh by 2 pi. If it is a wave form, angular moment nh by 2 pi. If it is a particle form, also mvr is equal to nh by 2 pi. In both cases, angular momentum is coincide. It means electron should have both wave nature and particle nature. That consideration, both wave and particle consideration is called quantum mechanics. Next. Next, Heisenberg uncertainty principle. Heisenberg uncertainty principle is against to Bohr's theory because Bohr proposed that existence of stationary orbits. What is meant by stationary orbit? The orbit in which the energy of electron remains constant. Electron eppudu ఇప్పుడు ఫస్ట్ ఆర్బిట్ లో రివాల్వ్ అవుతుంది కానీ ఇట్ ఆల్వేస్ ఎగ్జిస్ట్ ఇన్ ఫస్ట్ సెకండ్ లో ఉంటే సెకండ్ వెన్ ఇట్ రివాల్వ్స్ ఇన్ ది ఫస్ట్ ఆర్బిట్ ఇట్ నైదర్ లూజెస్ నార్ గెయిన్స్ ఎనర్జీ సో పొజిషన్ ఆఫ్ ఆర్బిట్ కెన్ బి క్యాలిక్యులేటెడ్ ఈజీలీ వెన్ పొజిషన్ దట్ ఈస్ ఆర్బిట్ నెంబర్ ఈస్ నోన్ దట్ యూ కెన్ ఈజీలీ డిటర్మిన్ ది ఎనర్జీ ఆఫ్ ఎలక్ట్రాన్ బికాస్ ఎనర్జీ ఈజ్ ఈక్వల్ టు -13.6 ఇంటూ జెడ్ స్క్వేర్ బై ఎన్ స్క్వేర్ Z is equal to 1 for hydrogen, it is constant. If electron present in first orbit, n should be 1. So you easily determine that value. So if stationary orbits exist, the energy of electron, the position of electron, and in which the electron revolves, that is the position, are also easily determined. But thus the determination is not possible given by according to Heisenberg. Heisenberg cancel this statement. Bohr given the stationary orbit. If you know the stationary orbit, you get easily determine the position of the orbit and the energy of the electron. If energy is known, you can easily calculate velocity. Velocity also formula V is equal to 2.188 into 10 power 8 into Z by N centimeter per second. It is obtained from MVR is equal to NH by 2 pi form. Velocity of electron. If N is known, then you get a velocity. If N is known, you get the energy. If N is known, you get the radius. If N is a constant value, you get these values. Bohr's proposed that existence of stationary orbits. Stationary means electron remains in that orbit only. It not goes to a higher level or not jumps to lower level. Because the concept of stationary orbit. Stationary orbit means when electron revolves in the circular orbit, it neither loses nor gains energy. If it gains, goes to higher level. If it loses, goes to lower level. But when revolves in the same orbit, it retains in that orbit. Ide orbit lo undi kabatti akkade exist avutundi electron, not move from any other side. So electron position is known. That electron position is N. N is known, then you get these values easily. But according to Heisenberg, the statement is wrong. Because suppose, do you visible electron through your naked eye? Do you visible the electron through your naked eye? But direct electrons, the blackboard consists of so many atoms. Do you visible these electrons? No. The electrons are observed through only electron microscope. In electron microscope, high energy light is focused on the electron. Suppose you observe the electron here through electron microscope. When you observe the atom and the electron is identified here through electron microscope, is it the correct position of electron? Whenever you observe through electron microscope, electron appears here. Without microscope, this is present at, is it a original position or any change? Microscope lakunda meer observe chesthe electron ekkada kanipisthe. If you observe through microscope, electron present here. Without microscope, where the electron is present? I already said, in electron microscope, there exists a high energy light. When a high energy light is focused on the electron, it appears here. When microscope is removed, higher energy falls on the electron is also removed. Then electron goes to either lower level or remains here. Energy is the conviction. Energy lane up the conviction. And the other one is the atom. And the second portion is the first orbit, second, third. మైక్రోస్కోప్ లో ఉన్న ఎనర్జీతో చూస్తే ఇక్కడ కనిపించింది. వితౌట్ ఎనర్జీ అబ్జర్వ్ చేస్తే అది ఎక్కడ ఉండొచ్చు? ఎయిదర్ ఫస్ట్ ఆర్బిట్ ఉండొచ్చు, లేదా సెకండ్ లోనే ఉండొచ్చు, చెప్పలేం. సో ద పొజిషన్ ఆఫ్ ఎలక్ట్రాన్ డిటర్మిన్డ్ ఈస్ నాట్ సర్టెన్, ఇట్ ఈస్ అన్సర్టెన్. ఎందుకంటే ఇఫ్ అంటే ఎలక్ట్రాన్స్ ఆర్ నాట్ అబ్జర్వ్ త్రూ నేకడ్ ఐ. మీరు ఇక్కడ కూర్చున్నారు, మిమ్మల్ని చూస్తాను కాబట్టి మీరు ఇక్కడ ఉన్నారని చెప్పొచ్చు. మిమ్మల్ని చూడకుండా మీరు ఎక్కడ ఉన్నారో చెప్పగలం అది. అలాగే ఎలక్ట్రాన్ కెనాట్ బి సీన్ త్రూ నేకడ్ ఐ, దే అబ్జర్వ్ త్రూ ఓన్లీ మైక్రోస్కోప్. ఎలక్ట్రాన్ మైక్రోస్కోప్ కంటే హై ఎనర్జీ. వెన్ హై ఎనర్జీ ఫోకస్డ్ ఆన్ ది ఎలక్ట్రాన్స్, దే ఆర్ ఎక్సైటెడ్. సో దిస్ ఈజ్ ఎక్సైటెడ్ పొజిషన్. దిస్ ఈస్ ద పొజిషన్ ఆఫ్ ఎలక్ట్రాన్ ఇన్ ఎక్సైటెడ్ స్టేట్ వెన్ అబ్జర్వ్ త్రూ మైక్రోస్కోప్. వితౌట్ మైక్రోస్కోప్ ఇట్ ఈస్ నాట్ ఎ రియల్ పొజిషన్. It is the position is less than or equal to this number. And either 1 hour or 2 hours. Mari, do you determine exactly the position of electron? It is not exact position. It is excited position. Electron appears under excitation here. Excite ayi vachche ikkada kanipistundi. Excite avanappudu ekkada kanipistundi? Danakanna lower position. Possible position 1 undi. Aithe 1 vachchu లేదా 2A ఉండొచ్చు. మరి 1 or 2A ఖచ్చితంగా చెప్పగలరా? చెప్పలేము. మరి అలా ఖచ్చితంగా చెప్పినప్పుడు ఎన్ ఇక్కడ 1 or 2A అనేది తెలియకుండానే వి కట్టచ్చు. అప్పుడు వీలో ఎర్రర్ వస్తుంది, అంటే వి ఆన్సర్ రాదు. అలాగే ఎనర్జీ ఎన్ చేంజ్ అవుతుంది కాబట్టి ఎన్ ఎనర్జీ మారిపోతుంది. కాబట్టి ఆల్ ద వాల్యూస్ క్యాలిక్యులేటెడ్ బై బోస్ థియరీ రాంగ్ అని చెప్పాడు. ఎందుకంటే ఇట్ ఈస్ ఇంపాసిబుల్ టు డిటర్మిన్ ది ఎగ్జాక్ట్ పొజిషన్ ఆఫ్ ఎలక్ట్రాన్. డూ అండర్స్టాండ్ దిస్? ఐసెన్బర్గ్ గివెన్ ద అన్సర్టనిటీ ప్రిన్సిపల్. అన్సర్టనిటీ మీన్స్ ఎర్రర్స్. వాట్ ఆర్ ది ఎర్రర్స్? ద ఎర్రర్స్ ఎగ్జిస్ట్ ఇన్ ద బోర్ వాల్యూస్ బికాస్ ఎలక్ట్రాన్ ఇస్ నాట్ అబ్జర్వ్డ్ త్రూ నేకెడ్ ఐ, దే అబ్జర్వ్ త్రూ ఎలక్ట్రాన్ మైక్రోస్కోప్. ఎలక్ట్రాన్ మైక్రోస్కోప్ హ్యావ్ హై ఎనర్జీ. వెన్ హై ఎనర్జీ ఫోకస్డ్ ఆన్ ది ఎలక్ట్రాన్, ద ఎలక్ట్రాన్ గోస్ టు ఎక్సైటెడ్ లెవెల్ అండ్ ఎక్సైటెడ్ లెవెల్ ఈస్ విజిబుల్. బట్ వాట్ ఈస్ ఇట్స్ రియల్ పొజిషన్? ఇట్ మే బి యాజ్ యూజువల్ ఆర్ ఇట్స్ లెస్ పొజిషన్. సో ఇన్ దిస్ కేస్ ఎన్ పొజిషన్ ఆఫ్ ఎన్ ఈస్ ఎయిదర్ వన్ ఆర్ టూ, ఎయిదర్ వన్ ఆర్ టూ బట్ నాట్ ఎగ్జాక్ట్లీ వన్ ఆర్ ఎగ్జాక్ట్లీ టూ. సో ఎన్ వాల్యూస్ అన్సర్టెన్. ఇఫ్ ఎన్ వాల్యూస్ ఎర్రర్ దెన్ విఈ అండ్ రేడియస్ ఆర్ ఆల్సో అన్సర్టెన్. దట్స్ ఐసెన్బర్గ్ అన్సర్టనిటీ ప్రిన్సిపల్ స్టేట్స్ దట్ ఇట్ ఈస్ ఇంపాసిబుల్ టు ఫైండ్ ద ఎగ్జాక్ట్ పొజిషన్ అండ్ ఎగ్జాక్ట్ మూమెంటమ్ ఆఫ్ ఎలక్ట్రాన్స్ సైమల్టేనియస్లీ. అదే ఇఫ్ ద పొజిషన్ ఆఫ్ ఎర్రర్ ఇన్ ద ఎలక్ట్రాన్ ఇస్ టేకెన్ యాస్ డెల్టా ఎక్స్, ఇట్ ఈస్ ద ఎర్రర్ ఇన్ ది పొజిషన్. ఎర్రర్ ఇన్ ది పొజిషన్ అండ్ డెల్టా పి ఇస్ దిస్ ద ఎర్రర్ ఇన్ ది మూమెంటమ్. మూమెంటమ్ పి ఈజ్ ఈక్వల్ టు మాస్ ఇంటూ వెలాసిటీ. మాస్ ఆఫ్ ఎలక్ట్రాన్ రిమైన్స్ కాన్స్టెంట్. ఇఫ్ వి చేంజెస్ పి చేంజెస్. వి దేర్ ఎగ్జిస్ట్ ఎర్రర్. వై? వి డిపెండ్స్ ఆన్ ఎన్. ఎన్ ఈజ్ అన్సర్టన్. ఎన్ హ్యాస్ ఎర్రర్. సో వి ఆల్సో హ్యాస్ ఎర్రర్ వాల్యూ. సో ఇఫ్ వి ఈజ్ ఎర్రర్ పి ఈజ్ ఆల్సో ఎర్రర్. కాబట్టి డెల్టా పి ఈజ్ ద ఎర్రర్ ఇన్ ద మూమెంటమ్. దెన్ ఐసెన్బర్గ్ షోస్ దట్ డెల్టా ఎక్స్ ఇంటూ డెల్టా పి ఈజ్ గ్రేటర్ దాన్ ఈక్వల్ టు హెచ్ బై టూ పై, హెచ్ బై ఫోర్ పై. డెల్టా ఎక్స్ ఇంటూ డెల్టా పి ఈజ్ గ్రేటర్ దాన్ ఈక్వల్ టు హెచ్ బై ఫోర్ పై. నెక్స్ట్ పి ఈజ్ ఈక్వల్ టు ఎంవి. డెల్టా పి ఈజ్ ఈక్వల్ టు మాస్ కాన్స్టెంట్ ఎం ఇంటూ డెల్టా వి. Substituted here and you get the formula delta x into delta v is greater than equal to h by 4 pi m. These two formulas are important. Heisenberg uncertainty principle. Heisenberg's uncertainty principle. Delta x is equal to error in the position. Delta p is error in the momentum. X and P relation is H by 4 pi. X and V relation is H by 4 pi M. Next, there's a deep, the Heisenberg's uncertainty principle rules out the existence of stationary orbit. Stationary orbit untai ane concept wrong ani cheppadu. We cannot determine the exact position of electron. Electron ekkada tirugutundi stationary orbit. Adoni అది నేకెడ్ ఐ ద్వారా డైరెక్ట్ గా అజ్యూమ్ చేసుకుని బోర్ చెప్పాడు. మరి అకార్డింగ్ టు హైసెన్బర్గ్ దే ఆర్ అప్లైడ్ ఎలక్ట్రోమాగ్నెటిక్ థియరీ. సో ఎలక్ట్రాన్ ఈజ్ నాట్ విజిబుల్ త్రూ నేకెడ్ ఐ, ఇట్ ఈస్ అబ్జర్వ్ త్రూ ఎలక్ట్రాన్ మైక్రోస్కోప్. అన్నది వెన్ ఎవర్ వీ అబ్జర్వ్ ది ఎలక్ట్రాన్ మైక్రోస్కోప్ ఎలక్ట్రాన్ అపియర్స్ ఇన్ ఎక్సైటెడ్ పొజిషన్ నాట్ ఇట్స్ ఎగ్జాక్ట్ పొజిషన్. సో పొజిషన్ ఆఫ్ ఎలక్ట్రాన్ కెనాట్ బి డిటర్మైన్డ్ easily, cannot determine accurately. So position of electron is uncertain. If position is not known, we cannot determine the orbit. Hence Heisenberg uncertainty theory rules out the existence of stationary orbit. This is the consequence of Heisenberg uncertainty principle. Write down that. The consequence of Heisenberg uncertainty principle is this theory rules out the existence of stationary orbits. This theory rules out the existence of stationary orbits given by Bohr. And second point, this theory is applicable for all microscopic particles like electrons, protons, neutrons. This theory is applicable for all microscopic and a very small mass particles, but not applicable to macroscopic particles. But not applicable to macroscopic particles, very big particles. Next. If the error in the position of electron delta x and error in the velocity of electron delta v are equal, then what is the value of delta v? If the errors in the position of electron and velocity are equal, then what is the value of delta v? Delta v is equal to how much? And according to Heisenberg, delta x into delta v greater than or equal, you take the equal h by 4 pi m. If delta x should be equal to delta v, so delta v into delta v, because delta x is equal to delta v, delta v into delta v, delta v square is equal to h by 4 pi m. Therefore delta v is equal to square root of h by 4 pi m. It is given like this, 1 by 2 into root h by pi m. Root h by pi m. 1 by 2 into root h by pi m. 1 by 2 into root h by pi m. Next, another question. If the uncertainties of position and momentum are equal, if uncertainties in position and momentum are equal, then what is the uncertainty in delta, uncertainty in velocity? If the uncertainties are position and momentum are equal, then the uncertainty in the velocity, delta v. Given that the delta x is equal to delta p. Since delta x into delta p is equal to h by 2 pi. Delta x is equal to delta p. So delta p square is equal to h by 4 pi. Or delta p is equal to root h by 4 pi. H by 4 pi. H by 4 pi. Delta p is nothing but m into delta v is equal to h by 4 pi. Delta v is equal to 1 by 4 by this and 2 into m kendaku vastundi, m into root h by pi. 1 by 2 m into root h by pi. These two concepts are most important. Bohr's atomic theory, hydrogen spectrum, and Heisenberg and de Broglie. Baga most important. Next, secondary thing. What is electromagnetic spectrum? Electromagnetic spectrum. Electromagnetic radiations are obtained when electric field and magnetic field are perpendicular to each other. If it is electric field, if it is magnetic field, when these correlation, you get the light. That light is called electromagnetic radiation. When electric field, magnetic field are perpendicular to each other. For this perpendicular side, light is obtained. So light is called electromagnetic radiation. The lights are different in energies. These are known as the arrangement of different electromagnetic radiations in the decreasing order of energy is called electromagnetic spectrum. The arrangement of different electromagnetic radiations in the increasing order of their energy. That is, first is gamma rays. Next, X-rays. There are the UV. There are the visible. Next, micro, tarvata radio, micro TV, TV waves, next radio waves, రేడియోలో ఫస్ట్ ఏఎం ఉంటుంది, తర్వాత ఎఫ్ఎం ఉంటుంది, లాస్ట్ లాంగ్ రేడియో వేవ్స్. ఫ్రమ్ లెఫ్ట్ టు రైట్ ఎనర్జీ అండ్ ఫ్రీక్వెన్సీ డిక్రీజెస్, ఈ అండ్ న్యూ డిక్రీజెస్, లాంబ్డా ఇంక్రీజెస్. దిస్ ఆర్డర్ ఈస్ ఇంపార్టెంట్. గామా రేస్, ఎక్స్రేస్, యువి, విజిబుల్, మైక్రో, టీవీ, రేడియో, లాంగ్ రేడియో. They given four radiations, UV and second gamma, third TV, fourth radio. Which has the highest wavelength? Which radiation have highest wavelength? Among these four, which has the highest wavelength? From left to right, wavelength increase. What is the last radiation among these four? Radio. Radio has the highest wavelength. They as well like that questions. Order must be important. Gamma rays, X-rays, UV, visible, micro, TV, radio and long radio waves. Next. This from left to right, energy and frequency decrease, lambda wavelength increase. Next. According to Planck's quantum theory, energy of electron E is equal to, in general, NH nu. Because black body emits energy in the form of packets. Black body emits energy in the form of packet. That energy packet is called quantum. The quantum consists of so many electrons. That electron's number is N. That electron with the energy is called photon. The energy of electron is called photon. One electron corresponds to one photon energy. But packet consists of so many electrons. So many photons are involved in the packet. That number is called N. If one electron or one photon, N is equal to 1. Here N is equal to number of photons. Important formula. N is equal to number of photon, not a proton. Photons. Photons means energy of electron. Electron energy is called photon. E is equal to NH nu. H is the Planck's constant. Nu is equal to frequency. Also, nu is equal to C by lambda. Where C is the light constant. Light constant and the C is equal to 3 into 10 power 8 meter per second. Or 3 into 10 power 10 centimeter per second. C value 3 into 10 power 8 meter per second or 3 into 10 power 10 centimeter per second. Number of photons calculate chairman at the thermometer. They give energy and frequency or wavelength. They calculate the number of photons. Next concept, photoelectric effect. Photoelectric effect. Photoelectric effect. When light energy focused on the metal surface, when light energy strikes a surface of metal, then ejection of electrons takes place from this metal surface. Ejection of electrons, that is a movement of electrons. Movement of electrons is called current. We apply the light energy, we get the current. Light energy means photo, current means electric. Photoelectric effect. When a certain frequency of light falls on the metal surface, then ejection of electrons takes place from metal surface. This phenomenon is called photoelectric effect. Certain minimum frequency. Electrons are bonded in the metal atoms. They are attracted with the nucleus. So the energy of applied light should remove the electron from nuclear attraction. Ala aithene photoelectric effect vastundi. Electrons are bonded with nucleus. Here nucleus, electron is tightly bonded with nucleus. When we supply the energy, electron goes to excited state and come from the atom. So it requires some minimum energy of light. So we applied the light energy, it is greater than the ఎనర్జీ రిక్వైర్డ్ ద రిమూవ్ ఆఫ్ ది ఎలక్ట్రాన్ ఫ్రమ్ న్యూక్లియర్ అట్రాక్షన్. ఈ న్యూక్లియర్ అట్రాక్షన్ నుంచి ఎలక్ట్రాన్ రావడానికన్నా ఎక్కువ ఎనర్జీ ఇవ్వాలి. వి నీడెడ్ ది హయ్యర్ ఎనర్జీ దాన్ దట్ ఆఫ్ ఎనర్జీ రిక్వైర్డ్ ద రిమూవ్ ఆఫ్ ఎలక్ట్రాన్ ఫ్రమ్ న్యూక్లియస్. ఈ న్యూక్లియస్ అట్రాక్షన్ నుంచి ఎలక్ట్రాన్ బయటకు తీయడానికి కావాల్సిన ఎనర్జీ కన్నా ఎక్కువ ఎనర్జీ ఇక్కడ ఇవ్వాలి. ద ఎనర్జీ రిక్వైర్డ్ టు రిమూవ్ ది ఎలక్ట్రాన్ ఫ్రమ్ న్యూక్లియర్ బౌండరీ ఈస్ కాల్డ్ థ్రెషోల్డ్ ఎనర్జీ అంటారు. ద మినిమం ఎనర్జీ దట్ నీడెడ్ టు రిమూవ్ ది ఎలక్ట్రాన్ ఫ్రమ్ న్యూక్లియర్ బౌండరీ ఈస్ కాల్డ్ థ్రెషోల్డ్ ఎనర్జీ. ద సప్లైడ్ ఎనర్జీ ఈస్ గ్రేటర్ దాన్ థ్రెషోల్డ్ ఎనర్జీ, దెన్ యూ గెట్ ద ఫోటో ఎలక్ట్రిక్ ఎఫెక్ట్. సో ఫోటో ఎలక్ట్రిక్ ఎఫెక్ట్, ఇఫ్ ద అప్లైడ్ లైట్ ఎనర్జీ ఇస్ హెచ్ న్యూ అండ్ థ్రెషోల్డ్ ఎనర్జీ ఇస్ ఈక్వల్ టు హెచ్ న్యూ నాట్, ఇఫ్ దీస్ టూ ఆర్ ఈక్వల్ జస్ట్ ఎలక్ట్రాన్ కమ్ బ్యాక్ బట్ నాట్ ప్రోపగేటెడ్, ఇఫ్ అప్లైడ్ ఎనర్జీ ఇస్ ఈక్వల్ టు థ్రెషోల్డ్ ఎనర్జీ జస్ట్ ఎలక్ట్రాన్ కమ్స్ అవుట్ ఫ్రమ్ ది న్యూక్లియస్ సర్ఫేస్ అండ్ అటామిక్ సర్ఫేస్ నాట్ మూవ్స్. ఇఫ్ యూ గివ్ ద ఎనర్జీ గ్రేటర్ దాన్ దట్ ఆఫ్ హెచ్ న్యూ, ఎలక్ట్రాన్ కమ్ బ్యాక్ ఫ్రమ్ ది కమ్ అవుట్ ఆఫ్ ది మెటల్ సర్ఫేస్ అండ్ గోస్ టు ఫార్వర్డ్, దట్ ఈస్ కాల్డ్ మూమెంట్. ఎనర్జీ కన్స్టిట్యూట్ టు మూమెంట్ ఆఫ్ ఎలక్ట్రాన్ ఇస్ కాల్డ్ కైనెటిక్ ఎనర్జీ. సో సమ్ ఎనర్జీ ఈస్ యూటిలైజ్డ్ టు రిమూవ్ ది ఎలక్ట్రాన్ ఫ్రమ్ న్యూక్లియర్ అట్రాక్షన్, రిమైనింగ్ ఎనర్జీ ఈస్ కన్వర్టెడ్ ఇన్ టు కైనెటిక్ ఎనర్జీ. దిస్ ఈస్ కాల్డ్ ఐన్స్టీన్ ఫోటో ఎలక్ట్రిక్ ఈక్వేషన్. This is called Einstein photoelectric equation. And a certain frequency of light, it should be greater than the threshold frequency. Threshold frequency means frequency of light removes the electron from nuclear attraction. If you apply the frequency greater than that, then electrons comes out from the metal surface. That phenomenon is called photoelectric effect. Next, KE is equal to H nu minus H nu naught. This is equation in the form of Y is equal to MX plus C. Straight line not passes through origin. E graph ela vastundi? Y ekka negative intercept lo undi. Intercept negative undi. Kaatte ikkada form avuthundi. కాబట్టి లైన్ ఇలా ఫామ్ అవుతుంది. ఇక్కడ కైనెటిక్ ఎనర్జీ, ఇక్కడ న్యూ. దిస్ గ్రాఫ్ ఇస్ లైక్ దిస్. ద గ్రాఫ్ ఇస్ లైక్ దిస్. ఇఫ్ ఫోర్ మెటల్స్ ఏ బి సి అండ్ డి ఆర్ గివెన్, ఫోర్ డిఫరెంట్ మెటల్స్ ఏబిసిడి ఆర్ గివెన్ and their photoelectric equations, graphical lines are drawn between KE versus nu, then the form of the graph. Is it all metals have same threshold energy? Anni metals ki equal threshold energy untunda? In case of smaller atom, electrons are bonded with nucleus strongly. In case of smaller atoms, electrons are strongly bonded with nucleus. So they request high energy. So this case, threshold energy is high, or threshold frequency is high. If a larger atom is considered, the electrons are loosely bonded with nucleus. In that case, threshold energy is very less. So threshold frequency is less. So as atomic size increases, threshold energy decreases. So smaller atoms have high threshold energy, larger atoms have less threshold energy. Here A, B, C, D are four different metals. So they have different threshold energies. So this gap is not equal for all elements. If it is for A, it is for B, it is for C, it is for D. The graph exists like this. KE versus nu. Same frequency is applied, but the threshold frequency is different. So this intercept is different. This is the graph of the type of four different metals. Okay, we stopped here. These are the secondary concepts: electromagnetic radiation, photoelectric effect, and energy. E is equal to NH nu. Do you understand why these gaps are arising? Because all elements have no equal threshold energy. Different metals have different threshold energies. It depends on its size. Okay.